Many wide complex tachycardias originate in the ventricles, but some do not. The ones that do not may include aberrant SVT like a bundle branch block or a ventricular reentry problem where the ventricles may contract too early after partial repolarization, like that of a pre-excited tachycardia or Wolff-Parkinson-White syndrome. A very common VTach is called monomorphic ventricular tachycardia. This means that all of the complexes are the same size, direction, and shape. This is usually caused by an ectopic pacemaker somewhere located in the ventricle. In this ECG, the rhythm is regular but may also be slightly irregular. The rate is around 1 to 200 beats per minute, and there are rarely any discernible P waves. There's no discernible P to R interval, and QRS complex is greater than 0.11 seconds and are characterized as wide and bizarre with no P wave to QRS ratio. Now, the main problem with this type of fast, wide, complex tachycardia is that hemodynamics are unstable. The heart rate is so fast that it inhibits the atrium to prefill and preload the ventricles prior to their next contraction. In this case, it's important to know if the patient is stable or unstable. If stable, learn more about why the patient may be experiencing this arrhythmia. Remember, wide complex ventricular tachycardia can sometimes be caused by heart disease, electrolyte imbalance, especially potassium, and a Q to T interval prolongation. If the patient is stable, order a 12-lead ECG to see if the rhythm is supraventricular or ventricular in origin. If the patient is unstable, immediate treatment is vital. Now let's look at wide complex polymorphic ventricular tachycardia. Poly, meaning multiple, describes the origin of the electrical foci in the ventricles well. In fact, polymorphic tachycardia is caused by multiple ventricular foci with the resultant QRS complexes varying in axis, amplitude, and duration. It can also be described as bidirectional VTach, which is another type of polymorphic ventricular tachycardia most commonly associated with digoxin toxicity, and this is known commonly as Torsades de Pointes. Along with digoxin toxicity, we can see polymorphic VT with hypomagnesemia and hypokalemia. Let's take a closer look at the ECG for polymorphic wide complex tachycardia. The rhythm is irregular with a rate between 200 to 250 beats per minute. There are no discernible P waves and there is no P to R interval. QRS complexes are variable but greater than 0.11 seconds and they're wide and bizarre. There's no P wave to QRS ratio. Now in torsades, it can sometimes appear that the apex of the V wave changes from top to bottom and back again. Torsades de Pointes, or TDP, translates as twisting of points. The most important thing to remember with this type and monomorphic wide complex VTach is that both can become pulseless VTach or VFib very quickly. It's important to remember that wide complex ventricular tachycardia can present with or without a pulse. We can even see pulseless VTach in cardiac arrest patients, but in most cases, pulseless VTach quickly deteriorates into ventricular fibrillation. Remember, pulseless VTach is treated the same as ventricular fibrillation, and recognition and immediate treatment is vital to a potential positive outcome. The ECG interpretation can be the same as pulsed ventricular tachycardia, but the difference is that the patient is unresponsive, not breathing normally, and pulseless.